Do you need to make personal, individual, financial statements? Well, in that case, you should start by looking at your profit and loss. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Profit and loss statement, sometimes called the income statement, shows how well you operated regarding how much of your earned money you were able to keep. It shows how well you did during a specific period of time. QuickBooks gives you the ability to compare profit and loss statements of different time periods. You can judge your progress regarding how you are operating financially from one time period compared to another time period. For example, let's compare how well you did for the first 10 days of June compared to how well you did in the next 10 days. Or we're really comparing Joe Schmo. So what you do is, from the icon bar, you open the regular profit and loss. Now what we're going to do, we're going to change the dates, and then after you change the dates, to isolate the time period you're analyzing, you then have to click refresh to get it to work. So, from June 1 of 2016, we have to change this, until June 10 of 2016, okay, change it to 2016. Now that we have the dates that we want, well, it changed without clicking refresh. Sometimes if you change the date and go to the left of your keyboard and push tab, the cursor jumps away and the numbers adjust themselves. So we're going to come to the corner and drag it and squeeze it closed so it populates half of the QuickBooks screen. And this is how well we did during the first month of June. We netted, during the first 10 days of June of 2016, Joe Schmo kept 500 out of the 1500 that he earned and only earned bartending income. But we can open the report again from the icon bar and again put the from date, but this time it will say June 11th until June 20th, and let's make them both 2016. Now, notice we can go to the corner, and then we can squash this one as well, manipulating the window, dragging it over. Now, this is how well we did in the first 10 days of June compared to how well we did during the second 10 days of June of 2016. Which one did better? Well, we kept about a third of the money that we earned in the first 10 days. But here, you see in the second 10 days, not only did we earn more because we also had landscaping income during that period of time, but you can see the net amount that we kept was more than half of the amount that came in. Or actually, it was about a third. The total that came in was 2,300, and this is approximately a third. So you see the expenses increased in proportion, or somewhat in proportion, to the income. And that may or may not be true, but at least by comparing the two financial statements for the two different time periods, you have a sense of how much money came in and why, and how much money went out during each respective time period and why, and the end result at the bottom. In our previous video, we discussed the idea of net income from operations. This is how well you did regarding income and expenses that relate to how you operate, or in the case of an individual, how well you're making a living regarding how much you're earning compared to how much you're able to save. Sometimes your income changes for a reason that has nothing to do with your normal income and expenses. If something like that happens to you, you should be able to see your normal income or normal profit from your normal operations and be able to compare that to your overall net income that includes the rare and unusual items of income or expense. And anytime you have an other income or other expense type of unusual situation, it will show up on the profit and loss below the normal net income from operations. This way, you can see the normal operating income and the overall net income in the same place. So let's keep comparing these two statements and let's do this example. Let's imagine that we forgot to record back on June 3rd that Joe Schmo, the person whom we're doing the home finance for, received a gift of $7,000. This is not a reoccurring source of income. It's not really reflective of how efficiently you or Joe in this case operated, because it's not earned income. And it's not really in your control who does or does not give you a gift. So it should not affect your income from operations when you're making a judgment of how well you operate. It should be put in the chart of accounts as other income type of account and not just an income type of account. So let's go to the chart of accounts and add that account so we can use it and record the deposit. We click List, Chart of Accounts, and in the bottom left of the chart of account window, we click Account, New. Now the type will not be income. The type instead will be other income. And then we click Continue. And other income with the cap locks on will put gift income. And you can get a gift regardless of how well or how bad you operate during the month. Click Save and Close, and now we have a place to record income that has nothing to do with our normal operations. And now let's record June 3rd's gift. Obviously, we should use the deposits window. So the deposits window, we go up here and we click Banking, Make Deposit. Now, it was deposited into the bank account, and it was deposited on June 3rd of 2016, because that's the year that we're using in our example, our little story. Now, the account that we use, it's coming into the Chase Bank account from the other income account, gift income, and the amount, $7,000. If there was a check number, we would put it here. If we had the name of the person, we could add them to the list, but these are just extra details. But look at the profit and loss at the minute we click Save and Close. Aha! The profit and loss on the left, look what happened. Their net ordinary income stayed the same. So you know how well you operated during those 10 days. But at the moment we recorded that transaction, you notice this other income appeared below the normal operating income, and it added $7,000 to the overall net income for the period. So even though you might have operated better in the 10 days between June 11th and June 16th, you still had more net income in the first 10 days because of that gift. Now let's do a second example. Let's imagine on June 23rd of 2016, someone broke in at night and stole $500 from the cash box. This would be an other expense type of account. And we could call it loss on theft. So let's record that and see what happens. First, we have to put the account in the chart of accounts. List, chart of accounts, account, new. The type will be other expense because you have no control over it and it's not part of your normal operations. Click continue. And the name with cap locks on, loss on theft. Click save and close. And now we have an account to record that transaction into. Now, I'm just going to make this a little longer. Now, we learned before that we use the banking write a checks window anytime there's a decrease in any bank type of account, including the cash on hand, because the cash on hand is a bank type of account. Now, the transaction says the date the money was stolen was June 23rd. So you have to make it June 23rd, and there was no transaction number associated with it. There's no payee unless you know the name of the burglar. But the account in this case is the account that we just made, loss on theft. So the money came from the cash on hand and went to the loss on theft. And the amount that the cash box decreased on June 23rd was $500. Now we click save and close. The amounts in the profit and loss on the right side did not change because June 23rd is after this time range. So let's do this. Stretch it a little. Change this to include June 24. Then push tab. Aha! Notice, as soon as the time range included the transaction, look what appeared on the bottom of the profit and loss. You can see that loss on theft showed up for the first time as $500. And notice, the gift income did not show up on the right because the gift income was recorded on June 3rd and the profit and loss on the right only goes up to June 10th. Notice the profit and loss on the left does not include the theft because the cutoff of this income statement is the 10th. Only the theft appears on the profit and loss on the right because the profit and loss on the right starts with a date long after the gift and finishes within the time period that the theft was recorded. Notice you still have the same amount of ordinary net income. Actually, it's a little different because we changed the date. But notice under the ordinary income, we have the loss on theft. And if we made an income statement for the entire month, it would show both the loss on theft and the gain. Remember, after you change the dates, you click refresh. Now you have the entire monthly operating net income plus whatever special gift you got, which is not under your control and does not reflect how you operate, minus the loss that you had, which is mostly not under your control and doesn't have anything to do with how you operate, to get the real net income during the entire month.